Hello, and welcome. I'm Xander, and this is the level 25 quest for the Rose. Nothing really too spectacular. Everything I'm wearing is better, but then again, I am level 30. So, let's get this going. Who there, Katarina? We've got a rough job ahead of us, and that's a fact. Matters are tangled enough, what with Malala's Mort snapping at our heels, but we still managed to grabble that first trinket without too much fuss. Biting back them other two treasures, though, that'll be a different story. Once the stray gets here, I'll explain what, or more to the point, who we're up against. Alright, we've two bubbles left in the list, the Silver Sorrows and the Black Sarcophagus. Let's see where we're at. Oi, where's Paramu got to? Underfoot, he's still looking to whittle the tail behind that bleeding sarcophagus. We'll not be cloying that stickler until we've at least an inkling as to what the bloody thing looks like. Treasures aside, I've been doing some digging on my own into these execution allies of the Grinning Curs, and I'm afraid the name weren't no coincidence. Katarina, you heard of the bloody executioners, I hope. It seems them curs was feeding from the famble one of the one of the nation's greatest pirate powers. This ain't no ordinary crew of cutthroats. Last with Limsa Laminsa, the bloody executioners wield a power and influence second only to the Admiral herself. They was none too fond of Merwub or her prohibition on piracy, and it was only the overwhelming threat posed by the Galarian Empire that what eventually convinced him to play nice with the Thalacracy. But pirates ain't ones to play nice for long. Now that one-eyed Hilfir ain't around to helm the ship, the solidarity of the bloody executioners has begun to show cracks. All the strongest captains and lieutenants have begun to form their own faction and are scrabbling to claim the top chair for themselves. Of course, not one bloody cove can agree with another on which way the executioners ought to sail. Among these new factions, though, is a group what is pushing to break free of the Admiral's grip completely. Turns out these reformists, as they call themselves, was the ones as took the Grinning Curs under their wing. Which means they've got possession of the last two treasures we've yet to cloy. Rumors round town say that even for executioners, these coves are bloody and ruthless and not to be crossed. We should sit this one out, Jack. Piss on Malala's contest. It ain't worth this kind of grief. We'd be inviting the wrath of a crew so large and dangerous that even the Admiral ain't keen on coming to blows with them. If they ever came after us, large or small, it don't much matter. They broke the code when they hit that maelstrom tub. Aye, the Grinning Curs are paying for that crime, but we'd be poor sudden excuses for rogues if we let the real culprits carry on unpunished. I mean, to see this job to the end, and that means biting back them treasures and handling out proper justice to them as deserve it. But Jack, listen, with all the infighting going on at present, us stabbing a short blade into one faction's toe ain't like to bring the whole executioner crew down upon our heads. Or down on our heads. Besides, them reformers buggers are so far split from the main mob that they've been avoiding the city altogether. Now, it's about time we got to work. Katarina, you're to track down our black market contact. I set him to looking into the Kerr's new allies a while back, so he should have some answers for us by now. The veil was lifted by a southerly this morn. That'll put the old man at his haunt in Lower Lenoshka. Here, take this sack of blunt and pay a visit to the House of Styx. Basically, he's giving me the gill to pay for the information. That's kobold territory, if you didn't know. The old man bribes them with ore and hires the biggest and meanest sods as bodyguards. Just be ready for your approach to be challenged. Challenged? I'm a rogue. Why do I have to deal with a challenge? I can just sneak past, can I not? So, okay, it'll be quicker to go out the gate. Maybe. Be quicker to go out the gate to middle. Perhaps, yeah. That's what I'm gonna wanna do. Bum 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 bum. So, hopefully things don't go a bit sour. I don't see why they would. But we are, it is the Rogues Guild, and well, just about every game known to mankind, any type of Rogues Guild or something, normally has some kind of like serious downside that ends up happening during their storylines. But who knows? This is Final Fantasy. Maybe it's different, because technically in this case, it's a sanctioned thing? I do enjoy speculating on storylines and sharing my speculations so you can see how things actually turn out. And compare them to my interpretations of what I see. I still think there's some kind of a setup involved. Sense a hostile presence. Kobold Dormant. I out-level this quest. This is actually pathetically easy, but I don't think it was really meant to be hard in the first place. Everything sounds so loud. Which doesn't make any sense, because I repeatedly turned the volume down on this game, and it's still always loud. Welcome to the House of Sticks, young rogue. You must excuse my hirelings and really? Nothing. Well, I guess I'll take this opportunity to... Can't turn it down much lower. Welcome to the House of Sticks, young rogue. You must excuse my hireling's enthusiasm for greeting visitors. Now, have you any cumbersome baggage of which I might relieve you before we begin our conversation in earnest? Yes, your sack of coin. Ah, heavy burden for one of your tender years to bear, but its weight has balanced the scales. The sum is paid, the deal is made. Let us speak of these reformists. The faction that so wronged the Code now seeks to peddle one of its stolen treasures, the earrings, better known as the Silver Sorrows. The deal, it is said, is set to take place at Costa del Sol. The buyer, a moneyed merchant from the Golden Sands of Ulda. The earrings will be out in the open, vulnerable. I would target the moment of the transaction were I so inclined, as the gentleman up there by the cabin appears to be, for he purchased this selfsame information. Though he attempts to disguise his identity, the stench of a soldier yet lingers. I know not where one such as he came to learn of my existence, but I suspect he works for a certain yellow-coated captain. Brave she is, but foolish. Stumble blindly into the underworld, and your groping hands will not save you from the holes at your feet. Sudden shall be her fall. Well, that sounds ominous. So, that's interesting. She could either end up dying, or he might have to save her, and then she'd be really angry because she already hates the Rogues Guild, and if she got saved by the Rogues Guild, that would piss her off even more, I guarantee you. Welcome back, Katerina. What information did the old man have on them reformists? Looking to unload the earrings, are they? Into an olden, no less. Can't say I'm surprised to hear the buyers from out of town. You won't find many Liminsons willing to melt coin on aught them coves are selling. Only the daftest of sods would go about funding them as a means to pull down the Admiral. Eh? One of Malala's lackeys arrived at the house afore ye. How do they know to... Bah, them curs we captured must have cackled during the shrew's interrogations. We'll have to assume the Yellow Jackets know what we know, and that means we'd best get on our arses to Costa del Sol right bleeding now. I'll handle this one, Jack. You and Katarina can wait here for Paramount. Oi, Vakeb, what in the hell's she playing at? After her, lass, she knows this ain't a solo job. Speak with Vakeb and Costa del Sol. Well, it just so happens that Costa del Sol is one of my favorite locations. Okay, where, oh where? Hiding in the bushes. I told ye to wait at the guild. I don't need... Well, it might be as I could use an extra mort in the shadows after all. Jack has his mind set on punishing the executioners, but me? I just want to skulk in, cloy them silver bits, and skulk out. I reckon that if I could manage that with none the wiser, then they wouldn't know who to come after. Finish the job without drawing me daggers, you know. It ain't exactly true to the code, but the shield of underworld honor won't stop them bloody killers from cutting you mates' throats and setting the sisters aglimmer. The guild's the only place would offer to take in a pirate stray like me, and I'll not see it burned to the ground. The deal's about to start. Stay wid when ye're been to head in. God, some of these sentences are a pain to read. Alright, here's what we know. The rich merchant what comes over from Olda is some old maid of old master Gurguruju the coal as owns Costa del Sol. Gurguruju's taking his guards a dancing dells and prancing off down the beach someplace, giving over the use of the entire resort to this friend. Seems she didn't want an audience for a bargain with the reformists. Which, as it happens, works out well for us. We'll wait until they're busy haggling over price, then snatch the sorrows and hope the twig before they realize aught's missed. Sound like a plan? And I'm going to get D-leveled down to 29, but that is fine and actually partly expected. There. The players have arrived. The reformers, coin counter, and the old and buyer are sitting up on the southeast platform. The earrings ought to be nearby. Hang about. Who are all these other calls? This place was meant to be empty. I see some nasty-looking blokes in old on garb, and are those mammoths? Ugh, that merchant's brought along a whole bloody entourage. I've gone and got ahead of myself. I should have realized the job would never be that easy. We'll have to mill a few of them bodyguards first, I reckon. You don't want to fight through a forest of blades should you get caught sneaking about up on them narrow walkways. Jack, I thought I'd... Stow your excuses, love. I know full well what ye were about. You start going soft on us, though, and it'll be like losing one of me arms. I can't take on the bloody executioners all by myself. It's only because I've got rogues like you and Underfoot and Katarina here that the guild can take the jobs it does. When our coves walk the shadows, it's the bleeding pirates what do the trembling. Remember that, Vicab. We ain't some two guild robbers what piss their breeches when their daddle's caught in the honeypot. We're the knives and the darkmans. Ain't no bastard wants to go blade to blade with the likes of us. I see you've not changed your mind, then. You'll need all the stabbers you can get, and I promise mine'll be there when you need 'em. Bane, now let's carve a path to that platform and bite back them earrings. Vakeb, you hide yourself down by the docks in case the marks escape during the fight. Katarina, you and me'll split up and mill the guards as we go. It's them puppets as concern me the most. I suggest you crash them little buggers afore they can spring any rum fun. Creeping as close as ye dare, and then click him right twixt the glazes. Most calls think a rogue will stab him in the back, but a sneaky attack from the front can be just as lethal. Once you're done with the first group, slip back into the shadows and move on to the next. Not to it, eh? I'll head over to the back while you start reading from the front. Let's wrap this before them jackets blunder in and scare off our marks. Why does it occasionally take off my poisons? That's kind of annoying and obnoxious. So my sneak attack's on cooldown. I'll just use internal release from the Kugelis tree to do more crits, and that should solve everything. And right, quick pace, actually. Seeing as how they are monks. Or Kugelis or whatever. That also means that they're using Second Wind, but I have that too. So, meh. Do I just kill everyone? Like, do I get on there and kill those? No, those are fighting already. I'm gonna leave the captain for last because I'm assuming he's going to be the most difficult of them to kill. Well, that was fairly close. Okay. Where am I in combat? Is it over here? Must be. And Jack's gonna heal me. So I'm assuming I was actually meant to kill that group up there with the help of Jack. I was supposed to like come over here and clear these out with them, but appears I've made a slight mistake in my directioning. Not that it really made much of a difference in the end. Duty complete. Really? That simple? Okay, what went wrong? Rogues! No one mentioned aught about rogues. What in the hells do you think you're doing? I am conducting a business transaction on behalf of the bloody executioners. Do you understand what that means? Do you know what they'll do to you? I'm all affrighted. Odd then that you're the one who's shaken. It don't much matter to me who ye work for. Your boss has broke the code, and we're here to collect. Those be the silver sorrows, then. I'm sure ye paid a caravan of coin for them shiny baubles, but I doubt they're worth your life. Let's have 'em, then. Wait, wait, damn you! You should know that this personage is an extremely influential member of the East Aldenard Trading Company. Surely you've heard of it. If the threat of reprisal will not stay your hand, then consider the political ramifications of interfering with a foreign dignitary. The Admiral would not desire you to damage Lemsa's relations with Alda. Yes, exactly. I'm a very high placed in Aldan society. I have powerful friends who would not be pleased were you to mistreat me in any fashion. And you must understand, the Silver Sorrows are a historical treasure, a gift once bestowed upon the Sultana Nasha Ulnasha by her champion. The earrings were later stolen from the royal vault, and we had lost hope of ever recovering them. That I might so easily purchase them, thus, is a miracle. The return to these trinkets will be, that is to say, the sorrows must be returned to Alda. Can you not look the other way for the sake of my nation's pride? You must think of me as some dull-witted thug. If this deal was being made on behalf of your country, then why are ye sneaking about consorting with pirates? An excellent point. One might doubt your quality of character were you to continue with these feeble fabrications. You need only entrust those earrings to me should you truly wish to see them returned to Alda, that is. After all, 'twas to fulfill that very purpose that the Holacracy bid on the sorrows in the first place. Bit late there, ain't ye, Captain? I think you'll agree this round belongs to us. On the contrary, my dear scoundrel, I made the winning move the moment I knew we were dealing with a merchant of Alda. I've come to bear an official order of seizure, authorized by the Admiral herself. You will not be harmed, but I must insist that you cooperate with this reclamation of unlawfully obtained goods. Though Costa del Sol is private property, it nevertheless lies within the state-governed territory. Come along quietly, and we need not inconvenience Master Garuju any further. These suspects will be taken into Yellow Jacket custody, and do not concern yourself with the Silver Sorrows. They'll be quite safe with me. So basically, she came in and just ruined everything. Kind of obnoxious of her, really. Bah, the hell's take that canary-colored harpy. You might as well have handed the things to her on a velvet cushion. I'll go find Underfoot and help him with his digging. There's still that last treasure out there, and you can be sure the reformists won't be giving it up without a fight. Aye, you do that. Been luck to ye, love. Ah, there you are. You left before events had truly been decided, and I thought you deserved to know the score. The Aldan merchant has acquiesced to our request and surrendered the Silver Sorrows into our keeping. We've also apprehended the reformist accountant and will be holding him for further questioning. Oh, born an associate of the bloody executioners. You yellow jackets don't flinch from your duty, I'll give you that. And what's this I hear about you buying information, Captain? I thought you'd sooner die than associate with elements of the underworld. I will do what I must to stay ahead in this challenge, and that marketeer's knowledge was vital to the case. 'Tis true I might find his practices distasteful, but he is no pirate. It is the fading era of piracy, which I mean to consign to the history books, and that chapter will never be fully closed until every pirate-spawned relic, including you and your guild, becomes a thing of the past. Valiant and forthright, these are the words by which the Yellow Jackets live. It is the manner in which we protect Limsa Limsa. I swore an oath on the graves of my sisters. No more shall the innocent suffer at the hands of these savage buccaneers, these unrepentant killers. And a grand oath it is. Me, I've got me fambles full just keeping the code intact. But the code is kind of an oath, too, when you get down to it. And since I've sworn to uphold it, I've no intention of stepping aside and letting ye trample all over me or me coves. In fact, you be better off giving in now before matters get proper serious. Just say you're sorry, admit defeat, and we'll leave it at that, eh? Your audacity knows no bounds. I am done wasting words. I shall reclaim that last treasure, and then I will look on victorious as your guild is dismantled brick by brick. Ah, that's the spirit, Captain. Just don't forget to keep an eye on them earrings. The city's crawling with rogues, you know. You can keep the sorrows in a bloody lockbox in the Coral Tower, but look away for a moment and one of me coves will bite them beauties right back. Come on, Katarina, back to the sisters for us. Bum ba da da bum bum. Oh, hey, my return is back up. So I believe there is two level 30 quests, something like that. Something like that. Yes. Well, after all that hard work, the shrew made off with the spoils. As far as her damn contest goes, I suppose that makes us even. It'll be the last treasure, this black sarcophagus, that decides the victor. Whatever the reformists are doing, keeping it bob, you can bet your grandmum's teeth there'll be some blade work needed before this job is done. Get yourself ready for a proper scrap, Katarina. Just grab the silver pieces. And that is all for now. I will see you guys next time. Have a good day.